Hey, all together, and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays. Looking good today on Catalina Letter Edition. New season, new maps, and some old maps. Actually, Catalina's only old map, but it's an awesome map. TVC, White Edition. And in the 5 o'clock position, I would say, in the red, it's for freeze effect, the red zone. And on the 9 o'clock position in the blue, it's me, Alex Usher. No, Tiger Terran. That's right, that's my Smurf. Yeah, on an A, like Smurf Tiger Terran. Yeah, there you go. So, whatever. I like this nickname. If I wouldn't have made myself a name, yeah, then Tiger Terran. Then I would choose Tiger Terran. As you can see here, I do have the War Chest SV skin. Looks a little bit different, but it's nice. I like it. It's okay. This is the Special Forces skin. Normally I wouldn't promote the War Chest or anything payment related, but I have to say some of those skins are badass. You should have a look. If you play StarCraft 2, give it a shot. Just have a look on the skins. The Leviathan. Don't know how it's pronounced in English. Skins for Zerg look awesome, and the Forged skins for Protoss look decent as well. So yeah, maybe, why not? Why not? So in this game you will see something I was telling you weeks ago, but I didn't show you. And I was like, maybe I'm not showing it to you. But now I thought, like, screw it. Just show them. Why wouldn't I? So here we go. Reaper, Marine, Rex guys, you know, whoops, Command Center, and so on. Scout in the wrong direction, which happens to me a lot recently. I don't know why. Maybe it's because of NA server, not Europe server. On Europe, however, most of the time I scout the right direction first, like 90% of all cases. At least that feels to me, but here it's the complete opposite. Second guess with the factory, so no 211, as you can see. Reaper jumps up, and yes, I have to admit this is a diamond game. I was currently ranked diamond in this game. However, I think this guy was Master League tier 3, if I'm not mistaken. So not the best, but also not the worst. So let's see what happens here. Some marines, that's... marines, look at that. I was wondering. So there we go. Reaper killed one drone and one circling so far. It's not bad. That is not too bad. There's a mule. That's the SCV icon. Special Forces SCV. SCV ready! Oh, the Reaper again! Getting another drone kill and forced us. Was this a spore? I think so. Yeah, a spore. So, overall, some damage dealt. Yep, that's not bad. I don't know why drones don't count as lost minerals. That's stupid. They should. But, okay. And here come the circlings, scouting for the Reaper. As you can see, I'm going for the 4, and here should soon go. Come on, yes, the medivac. So the medivac takes 30 seconds to Thor, 43, so go for the 4 first. Get the armory in time. Armory takes half a minute and 6 seconds, so 36 seconds is a long time. So I need to make sure. I don't have a fixed build order for this yet. I'm just freestyling in Master League with Mac, and it works. That's the fun part. He didn't scout it. Well, maybe he did scout the factory, but that's not unusual. Factory standard, like Hellions and Banji, standard stuff, normal stuff, nothing special. However, what's not normal is the 4 drop. Come on. Damn. Boosting across the map. Thor drop. This is the Thor drop song. And here comes the Thor drop against Darklings. The fun part is why Whoopsie, that Whoopsie works so good is with the recent patch, which happened like 2 months ago or so, the Thor got some major difference. And back at home we get the other Thor. And this difference is so important. Normally this would have never worked. Zerglings would have eaten this Thor, but now the Thor got plus one more armor, so two in total. Each Zergling will only deal 3 damage instead of 4. By the amount of Zerglings around the Thor, this is like a lot. Now he got Hydralisk, which can be a pain in the ass, but still, you just continue with the harassment, killing a drone or so, getting the Hydralisk kill, and the Hydralisk kill, this is so good. Just don't lose the Thor. It's the same with the Battlecruiser, don't lose them. Especially if you play mech. The good thing here is, yes, he could go for roaches, but you can counter repair and drop in micro the Thor. Somewhat. It's possible, you just need to be in his face. That's the main part, be in his face. And by the time you can move out, you got tanks and Thor and can drop the Thor and micro them and have them behind the line and kill the Ravager and stuff like that. So as you can see, I'm just 5 SCVs behind so far. That's good. That's good. The third base is up. His fourth base not up, not on the way. It's not good. Double Thor drop on the way. And you just continue. You can stop by with 2 Thor. You can go up to 3, maybe 4. However, 4 is a little bit overkill. I think like 2 to 3 is optimal in this solution. Yeah. You can deal a lot of damage. Thor have great DPS. Like, they deal 30 damage twice. Look at that. The queen just takes a lot of damage. The good thing is it's flat damage, so they deal this damage against everything ground related. Light units, heavy units. Just don't lose the Thor. And you just continue. Go back, heal them up, boost again across the map. Of course, you give him time. You know, now he can spread his overlords and his creep. You could pair those Thors with some Hellion harassment, however, to increase the potential of harassment. So you not only do the Thor drops to threaten his economy or his tax structures. Potentially the Hydralisk then morphing to Lurker then would be such a tech structure. But you also only go with the Hellions. With the Hellions to deal heavy damage to his economy as well. So that would be nice. And so far the Thor got some kills, so that's not too bad, I would say. And I am supply wise quite okay, I would say. It's looking okay. There's nothing difficult or nothing strange here. The Thor drops are working on. And you see how fast the Hatchery takes damage. Okay, it's not as super efficient. Also, this Thor not attacking is bad because of this attack here. But yeah, they just shrek this. So, I don't know about this Hydralisk attack. Hydras are strong, especially if they got the upgrades, which they have. So they deal a lot of damage here to me, but the tanks should do their duty. That's looking fine. Interesting. Okay. Oh, and also go for the payload, yeah. Not explosive, but the high impact. Just deals more damage. You can clear out overlord super fast. You just need to know when to micro your Thor back to not lose them. They are very important. And so far, those Thor did a good job, I would say. Yes, I lost a lot of SCVs, but I'm only behind 10. Look at those. The 29 kills, 27 kills. That's a lot of kills. That's a lot. That's good. And as long as you can keep them active and alive, later on you can do a double Thor drop as long as not a massive amount of Mutalisks is out. But Thor got buffed over the course of the year quite a lot. The Javelin missile launcher attack splash radius got increased by 0.1. Doesn't sound much, but magic boxing with the Mutalisk is not as easy as it was before. They got good attack against armored units, more range, the armor, base armor increase as well. They are awesome. They are not overpowered, but now they are strong and a real threat to any other unit on the field. And you just can be a pain in the ass here with the Thor. You just don't lose them. There's the Hellion attack. As I said, that's what you want to do. I should have done this earlier, but it's okay. Now I'm clearing out this field. Being annoying, drop there again. Just be active, don't lose your stuff, and you should be fine. Yeah, nice barbecue. Bam. Dropping here, killing some drones. Why not? And again, 10 more drone kills. 42, 35 kills with only two Thor drops. And I can continue this over and over again. As long as they don't die. If they would die now, it would be sad, but not massive. And I would say the basic idea behind this is to just stress around. Banshees are good, but they are not that good. I can't control them well enough with the cloak to make them viable. But the Thor, they come unexpected and strong. Now I'm forcing him to all in, doubling the army supply soon, the worker supply, I mean. And he just A moves into a siege tank line, and that's it, GG. 45, 44 kills. Two Thor, and of course the medivacs. With the upgrades, look at that, four armor. Four armor. A circling now would deal one damage with each attack. That's nothing. And even the Hydralisks are on 13, so 9. 9 is nice, but So that's that. Okay, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I wish you, as always, a very nice day, and goodbye. Hey, oh there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye bye.